Hello and welcome to our channel. In one of our previous videos, we talked what makes a great domain. And today I want to show you how to get some really great domain names. And like I mentioned before, a lot of great domain names are already taken or are selling for thousands and thousands of dollars, especially in .com domain zone. So today I want to show you some tools and tricks on how to find a great domain name, some short, really nice domain names. So let's start with impossibility.org. It's a great online tool that helps you find some great domain names by adding adjectives, verbs, or nouns to the beginning or the end of your domain name. So let me show you how it works. So for example, you're looking for a domain name that contains web design, but obviously a domain name like webdesign.com or .ca is already taken. So in this case, let's put web design and try to search for available domains. So as you can see, they're suggesting us safe web design, which is something you might not come up with earlier. And there's quite a lot of suggestions. Some of them don't really sound good with web design, but they might work with some other niches. So for example, if you have a company that sells t-shirts and you're looking for a domain name that contains that word, so let's search for t-shirt. And as you can see, they have some interesting suggestions here for us. And let's give it one more try. Let's say we're running a furniture store. So let's put furniture in our search and let's look what we have. So they have also some interesting suggestions for us. And you can also try playing with the kind of a word that you want to add in the beginning or the end of your words. For example, you can try playing with verbs and it will also suggest you a different set of domains. Usually it's the best idea to have a short word in the beginning, but you can also try to play with these options and see if maybe there's some better 5-character adjectives that work better for you. So this is a great way to find a domain name that looks and sounds good. Another great website to use when looking for some domain names is Name Mesh. So basically you have to put a couple of keywords and they will try to look for some great domain names for you. So let's try to put website design and see what kind of options we get. And as you can see, they're looking across a huge variety of domain zones, and they also suggest you some great options here. Let's give it another try and try to put something like Furniture Toronto and see what kind of options we get. And as you can see, we're getting some interesting options here. Like I mentioned in our previous video, they're using hyphens and they're using .co and some other domain extensions. This doesn't mean that they will always suggest you something really great, but you might find some great, great suggestions over here. One more interesting tool to look at is shortdomainsearch.com. This is a tool that works slightly different. Instead of looking for specific keywords, this tool helps you find some short domain names. So while it's really hard to find a 3-letter .com domain name, you will most likely won't find anything. But if you are looking for something else, like for example, if you're looking for IO, you might still be lucky and find something interesting that might work for your company. So for example, if you're Smith Lawyers and you're in Toronto, you might find a domain name like SLT, which would sound really good. But also you can look for a 4 or 5 letter domain names and maybe something will be available. So in this case, you will have to just brute force this website and search for some interesting domains that might work, maybe not specifically for your website, but you can use them as domain shorteners or URL shorteners for your website. You might also use them as a promo for certain things, etc., etc. But this is an interesting tool when you're looking for something really short and you're not sure what exactly you're looking for, but this tool will help you find some really interesting short options. Another great tool that I found a couple of years ago, there are also some great alternatives, but this is a tool that helps you find out whether your domain name is available across other social networks and other platforms. So for example, if you're looking to purchase a furniture store Toronto domain name, for example, and it will check whether the .com domain is available, whether the Twitter handle is available, whether you can create a Facebook page, Pinterest, YouTube channel, Instagram, etc., etc. Because in most cases, you want to get a really nice handle for your social networks as well as your website. So for example, if your domain name is furnituretoronto.com, it would be great to have an Instagram handle and a Facebook group that have the same URL, for example, facebook.com/furnitureToronto or instagram.com/furnitureToronto, etc. So this is a great way to check across all these popular platforms whether your name is available. And this is just one more option when you're looking for domain names. This one's called Nameboy. You just put some keywords, for example, furniture store Toronto, and it will generate some domain names based on this information that we provided. And these are just a lot of interesting options that while you might not use, it will be interesting to see what options are available, and maybe you'll come up with some other names. And last but not least, a great idea is to come up with some interesting word that sounds nicely and it looks good and it works for your business. So for example, when we are registering domain name for our company, we couldn't find anything that would work for us, and we came up with this word Verdix. Sounds a lot like Verdex. And we picked the domain name Verdix Media, and it worked really good for us. It was available. We were able to pick .com and .ca domain zones, and most others are available as well. We don't have a lot of competitors that are ranking for this word. The only problem that we had in the beginning is that Google was trying to suggest that to correct the word to Vertex. But eventually that also disappeared. And so this is an interesting way of coming up with some original unique name that will work great for your business. And in this case, it would be much, much easier to find a great domain name for your company. But obviously the downside for it is that if you already have a company and it has a different name, you won't be able to use this technique. All right, these are all the tips that I have for you today. If you have some interesting techniques and ideas that you're using when looking for domain names, please share them down below in the comments. If you have any questions also, please comment down below. We'll try to help you. And please hit that like button, subscribe to our channel. We're going to be uploading a lot more content soon.